Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome to AWS This Week, and there are some awesome announcements this week, including Elastic File System now supports identity and access management, AWS Backup now supports cross-region backup, EFS Single File Restore, as well as automated backup for EC2 instances, EC2 Spot Instances can now be stopped and started, and we announce our Guru of the Week. You're watching AWS This Week with me, Faye Ellis. Elastic File System now supports identity and access management. And if you haven't used Elastic File System before, it's a fully managed network file system which enables file sharing for Linux systems. And you can now use identity access management to manage client-specific permissions, for example, enforcing read-only permissions for specific identity access management roles with access requests logged in CloudTrail. So there are three great new announcements for AWS Backup, which is a centralized backup service which allows you to backup data on EBS volumes, RDS and DynamoDB databases, as well as Elastic File Systems. So firstly, AWS Backup now supports cross-region backups, so you can now backup your data to a different region, which is great for companies who have compliance requirements to keep a backup of critical data in a different region for disaster recovery. And the second announcement is that you can now restore a single file from an EFS file system instead of having to restore the entire file system. And this is great news because this means that if you only need to restore a single corrupted or accidentally deleted file, you don't have to wait for the entire file system to be restored. And the third announcement for AWS Backup is that you can now run on-demand or scheduled backup and recovery for EC2 instances. Now, previously, AWS Backup only covered the instance's EBS volumes, but now it will backup everything, including instance type, security group, identity access management role, and VPC, which all gets stored in an AMI. So then you can restore your EC2 instance in just one step. EC2 Spot Instances can now be stopped and started, similar to on-demand EC2 instances. And if you haven't used Spot Instances before, they allow you to take advantage of unused EC2 capacity at a generous discount of up to 90% compared to the on-demand price. And with Spot Instances, you set a maximum price that you're willing to pay. And if the spot price exceeds your maximum, or when capacity is no longer available, your instance will be terminated, stopped, or hibernated. And with this new announcement, you can now stop and start your Spot Instances yourself, assuming that capacity is still available and within your maximum price range. So on to Guru of the Week. And the correct answers this week were A and C, and not many people got this one right, but the person with the best answer is Denis Zaitsev. And Denis is a system engineer at AWS in the Ukraine. So congratulations to Denis. There's a Cloud Guru t-shirt, sticker, and hand-signed card on the way to you in the post. And you are also in the draw to win the free ticket to reInvent 2020. Please see the link below for this week's question, which is now live on our forum. And that's all from me. You've been watching AWS This Week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and I'll see you next time.